dear. I'm Aunt Cheryl. This here is Alex, Madison, and Angelica. You're from the United States and part of a feminist group determined to spread equality. You need to treat our family.
Being treated how we deserve, actually. We're women, we cook and sew.
Please, just hear us out.
We're feminists. We support equal rights between men and women.
But I don't see the problem. We're fine.
Really? So you two are being treated with honor and respect at home.
We're just doing what we're supposed to do.
Here's an example. When I was in seventh grade, I was in a gym class with all boys. No one ever wanted me on their team for sports because I'm a girl. That's called sexism. I wasn't being treated equally because of my gender.
You shouldn't have been playing sports in the first place. You're a girl. It's against the rules.
But no, today, in the U.S., girls can do more than just cook and sew. We just aren't always treated fairly about it.
You don't just have to cook and sew in the U.S. You have arranged marriages.
No, none of us heard arrangements.
But I don't understand.
Me neither, Danae, but it sounds wonderful.
Just one perk of living in the U.S. is that you'll get a good education. Now, doesn't that sound exciting?
Still, it's just so... different.
Maybe this will help.
Not smart, too dissonant, too chubby, not pretty. We're demoted, brought down, discriminated against. Boys, listen up, you're past your third best. We really don't appreciate this, and it isn't right.
We're ready when we need to stand up and fight.
That there were two boys in our class, and they were heading to MIT.
I was the first female Division I polo coach, and the other coaches at meets wouldn't greet me.
And so if you were a girl, you had to just keep up or be quiet.
My mom is 50 years old, and her options when she was in high school were swimming and cheerleading. I wanted to be a pole vaulter in high school, and that was something that wasn't done by girls in the United States.
Definitely no hockey. That would have been way too aggressive. Because yes. We're fragile, remember?
We want you to come with us to the U.S. and see what it's like.
Maybe.
You'll still have issues over in the U.S.
All right.
Do you actually understand what we're trying to say?
I sure hope you do. You know how hard it is to come up with that off the top of your head?
Luckily, I do understand.
Awesome. We'll help you to pack and we'll be on our way.
Hey, what are you doing? You're not supposed to leave the house. Come back.
No! 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 Come on, let's go! Let's go! Do you need a band-aid?
Wow, this is so exciting!
and don't be afraid, because your words and deeds will help people until the end of
time.